Hello students, here in this video we are going to see a problem on calculation of change in length of a bar. And here we have a question regarding that. A bar of uniform cross-sectional area 100 mm square is subjected to forces as shown in figure. The diagram is given. In this diagram we have this bar divided into three parts, that is AB, BC and CD. In AB portion the length is 300 mm, in BC the length is 400 mm and in CD it is 600 mm. Next, we have to calculate the change in length of this bar. Take capital E, that is Young's modulus, as 2 into 10 raised to 5 Newton per mm square, that is megapascal. Now whatever is given here, I'll write that in the form of data first. Now, a bar is of uniform cross-sectional area, so area is same throughout, that is capital A is equal to 100 mm square. It is subjected to forces as shown in figure, the value of forces are given. Then there is length of AB, so I'll write down length of portion AB, that is L suffix AB, it is 300 mm. L suffix BC 400 mm, L suffix CD 600 mm. Then calculate the change in length of the bar. Change in length of the bar is denoted by delta L. This is what we have to calculate. Capital E, Young's modulus is given, 2 into 10 raised to 5 megapascal, which is nothing but 2 into 10 raised to 5 Newton per mm square, because 1 megapascal is 1 Newton per mm square. Now this is the question we have. In order to find the change in length, we should know how much is the change in length in portion AB, similarly in portion BC and in portion CD. We are going to find individual change in length and then we are going to add them to get the total change in length of the bar. And for this purpose, what we have to do is, we have to take this bar one at a time. That is, first I'll start with portion AB and calculate the deflection here. One important point we have to note here is that whatever section of the bar is in the middle, like if I see in this question, BC is the portion of the bar which is in the middle, this portion, the deflection of this has to be calculated in the end. That is, first we are going to calculate deflection of AB, then CD, and at last we will go on to BC. So how to calculate this, let us see here. Solution. Since deflection of bar in portion AB is given by deflection in portion AB, is the formula is delta L suffix AB, since I am calculating it in portion AB, that is equal to PL upon AE, this is in section AB. Here I'll separate this portion AB of length 300 mm. So I have separated this portion. Next, on AB portion there are two load acting, one is at is 1 kN and the other is 3 kN, but we have to see this, that this portion B, it is the junction of AB and BC, so this 3 kN is the total value when we are adding AB and BC. So what I have to do, I'll take this load acting at A, which is 1 kN, because this is a single load, not at the junction. So So here I have 1 kilonewton. Now to balance this 1 kilonewton, I need to have, since this is acting towards right, to balance this we should have another load which should be towards left. Now as we can see in this diagram, this load is compressive, so we have to take it as negative. So therefore deflection in portion AB, it will be equal to, load will become negative, so minus 1 into 10 raised to 3 newton, length is 300 upon area is given as 100 and Young's modulus is 2 into 10 raised to 5. So from this I'll get the deflection in portion AB. This comes out to be, my answer is minus 0.015 mm, and since this value is negative, it indicates decrease in length. So here I am writing that it is indicating decrease, that is the length goes on reducing and diameter will go on increasing. Next, after finding deflection of bar in portion AB, now as I have told, we have to first find the deflection of the bar which are at the extreme end. So here I'll find the deflection in portion CD. So I'll write down, since deflection of bar in portion CD is given by, that is deflection in CD is equal to PL upon AE in portion CD. And for this purpose, again as I have taken AB separate, here I'll separate CD whose length is 600. Length is given as 600 mm. Then here even in CD portion we have 4 kilonewton load and 2 kilonewton load, but this 4 kilonewton is formed at the junction, that is when BC and CD they meet, at this point we are getting the total load as 4 kilonewton. So we don't have to take this load, we have to start from the free end, that is here there is 2 kilonewton load. And as we can see, previously AB was subjected to compression, now CD is subjected to compression, so deflection will become PL upon AE for portion CD, and that is equal to load, since it is compressive I have to take it as negative and the value is 2 kilonewton, so it is minus 2, I'll multiply 10 raised to 3 so that it converts into newton, into length of the member is 600 upon area is constant throughout, that is 100, Young's modulus is 2 into 10 raised to 5. So therefore I'll get deflection in portion CD which will be negative, and the answer is, I have it as 0.06 mm, and since it is negative it means there is decrease in length, so decrease. Now after getting deflection in portion CD, I'll say that similarly deflection in portion BC is given by deflection in BC is equal to PL upon AE for portion BC. Now portion BC, It has a length of 400 mm. I'll separate it. Now, as we can see, portion BC on B, the load is acting 3 kN. On C, the load is 4 kN. So there are two different values of load. Now, which value to select? That is an important question. I'll start with junction B. Earlier, when we were at B for portion AB, here I was having 1 kN load towards left. And if I see here, we are getting 3 kN load, which is towards left. It means at B, I have to add a load of 2 kN so that this 2 when gets added with 1. So at the junction, I'll get it as 3 because both are acting towards left, 1 kN and 2 kN. So 1 is towards left. Next, to balance this, we should have another load which should be towards right. So now if we see, if I compare this here, in this case, in portion C, here it was 2 kN towards right. Here also I have 2 kN towards right. So 2 and 2, that becomes 4. And in total here we have 4 kN towards right. So it is correct. It has been balanced. So now I'll say that this is tensile load. So therefore it has to be taken positive. Value is 2 into 10 raised to 3 Newton. Length is 400. Area is 100. Young's modulus 2 into 10 raised to 5. So from this I'll get deflection in BC. My answer is plus 0.04 mm. This answer is positive because the load is tensile, and here since it is positive, I'll say that it means increase in length. So increase. Now finally I can get the total deflection because that was the question. So here, therefore, total deflection in the bar is given by total deflection is denoted by delta L, and that is equal to delta L for AB plus delta L for BC plus delta L for CD. So therefore, I'll go on putting the values. Delta L for AB, it was minus 0.015. In portion BC, it is plus 0.04. And in CD, it is minus 0.06. So if I calculate this, my final answer is delta L is equal to minus 0.035 mm. So here I can say that therefore the total effect of all the loads is to decrease the length of the bar. So this is the total effect. There will be decrease in length of the bar as our answer is negative. So if we look into the question, here the unknown was, they were telling us to calculate the change in length of the bar subjected to various kinds of load. And here we have found out that change in length is minus 0.035 mm, and with this we complete the question.